being in the military, you're not there for yourself. You're there for the person next to you and the people back in the United States if you're overseas somewhere. The mission is first and you care about your people, but you can't forget to care about yourself.
So the first event that started maybe getting me thinking about myself not being right for the first time was a training exercise where I was supposed to go into a mock-up of a desert village with a bunch of injured patients. And hearing the sounds from outside of that room really started to trigger something. It took me a long time. Eventually I did open the door and go in and complete the exercise, but I finally got to a point where I knew I just was not right and got in the car and called my mom and said, I need help, I need you to come out here. And that was kind of the beginning of that controlled detonation.
From a design standpoint, I like to think of conflict, because every design is a story of conflict. If there isn't conflict, there's nothing of interest, there's nothing to keep the story moving.
Initially, our first several hours together was recounting stories that became increasingly more in-depth.
Seeing all the post-it notes and pictures and thumbnails of, you know, helmets and flight wings and helicopters, like everything captured a part of what I experienced.
The design that we came to really pulls together two of the concepts that kept recurring. The central concept is that controlled detonation, you know, symbolized in this design with the unexploded mortar that has to be contained before it can be dealt with safely.
It kind of brought up even the little things that I didn't necessarily think about that were a big deal. I could look at that and be like, yeah, that is me on a piece of paper.